Hey, what's up guys? My name is Moda and welcome back to the Mighty Stacker YouTube channel. Today's video, we do have a nice little update on that Bitmain Antminer T21. That is that three-phase BTC ASIC, right? So we do have a good update for at-home miners. There is a confirmed way now to run it on single phase, right? And it's as simple as it seems, right? So we're gonna talk about what you need, how much it's gonna cost you, and if it's gonna be worth the difference of price in comparison to the S21, which is already made for single phase or for more at-home miners, right? So we'll talk about those differences and we'll see if this thing's worth it, right? So if that sounds good, guys, stay tuned. Let's get to this thing. So in case you kind of forgot, the T21 is a BTC miner, again from Bitmain. The big difference with this guy, why it didn't get a whole lot of attention, was the fact that it was three-phase, okay? It's an air-cooled three-phase unit, so not made for residential at-home miners, right? So this thing did not get much love. We'll go over the specs real quick. 190 terahash in regular mode at 3,610 watts, 19 joules a terahash. The biggest difference, aside from the three-phase factor, was the fact that this guy was a good amount cheaper than the S21. Right, and it's also because it's not as efficient, but again, for the price difference, at least when it was announced, it was pretty great. Now though, ultimately the S21 has been going down and this guy's been kind of staying in the same range, so the price difference isn't as dramatic, but there is a good price difference, right? So when compared with the S21, yes, it's more efficient, but not by a ton, right? Not enough to justify the price difference, right? So this guy is 200 terahash, so about 10 terahash more, 3,550 watts, bringing you to a 17.75 joules to terahash efficiency, right? So we can see already it's not much, and factor in people have been having issues with this thing being in a hotter climate, not necessarily even like crazy hot, but hot enough to the point where they're not getting that efficiency because those fans are ramping up, bringing them closer to like a 18 to 19 joules of terahash efficiency anyway. Right, so that little bit of difference in some cases may be gone depending on your climate, depending on the time of year also, right? One other pretty big thing to factor is that the T21 does have a high power mode and it can run at freaking 233, right? Well, that's with the factory PSU, and also your efficiency is going to go down to the point where it's going to be 22 joules a terahash. It's over 5,000 watts, right? So you're not going to be doing that on like a factory PSU. You're going to need something like one of these, I don't know if you guys remember from back in the day, the Alpha Miner PSUs, which are made for overclocking, right? So don't be surprised to see them release like a little kit in the future, something there, right? Because you would need something definitely beefier to do that mode. Obviously, it's going to be dependent on what's going on, but like when BTC weren't like in the thick of it going through that bull market, you're going to want to ramp that thing up. That is another option, especially because you are going to have to change the PSU, right? We'll get to that here shortly. Let's get to it now, actually. So this was the big thing, right? Don't need much at all whatsoever, actually. All you need is a APW12 PSU, which is any of the ones that are on the S19s. You're going to have an old one laying around. You can buy a new one. Again, if I'm getting a new unit, though, I'd be buying a new PSU, right? So you would just need that. You would need the S19 bus bars. You can run LuxOS. That way it'll recognize it. You'll have no issues running it. And you'll be at 180 terahash at 3,520 watts, right? So again, all you need is that PSU, those bus bars, and you're on your way, right? Shout out to Altair Tech again for giving us the alpha. Again, they are a must follow if you are into BTC mining hardware. Always giving us these good tidbits, and they do have these things for sale on their website. They are a very good resource for parts, right? From anything, PSUs, control boards, fans, whatever, cables, all that stuff. They sell all these parts also. The bus bars are 20 bucks. You can get a new PSU from them for about $200, right? So it's up to you whether you want to get a used one or if you happen to have one laying around, but they do have them available there. That's literally it, right? So not much there. Now let's look at the difference in price though, right? So when we look at the T21 currently, we'll use their prices so we can compare. They have it listed at $34.99, right? So there is only the one variant. It's just that 190T model. So it's $34.99 in comparison with the S21 coming in at $41.49 for the lower model. Okay, so there is a pretty good price difference. But again, if you go the T21 route, you have to factor in that you do have to get that new PSU, right? Between the PSU, those bus bars, gonna be about $250 or so. So you do have to factor that in. But one key thing is that you can resell that original PSU that it came with, potentially, if you're able to find a buyer, right? Which I'm sure you will be able to, because again, a lot of these farms, the people who will be having them do need these extra parts on hand, right? So just to give you a sneak peek, this is the APW17, which is the S21's power supply, and it's $400, right? So even if you were to do like a one-on-one swap, you could potentially sell it around in that range. But even if, again, if you give them a deal and pretty much sell it for the price of one of these guys and the bus bars for $250, it's an even trade essentially, right? But again, the tricky part would just be finding that buyer. Maybe they have connections with farms who will be looking for these things, because again, this now makes it appealing for at home miners. So it may be a good way for these farms to get extra PSUs on the cheap, right? So something to factor in there. So again, $34.99 for that guy. The S21, theirs is $41.49, right? So the price difference isn't as dramatic, but it's mainly because the prices on the S21s have been going down. Wouldn't say aggressively, but they've been going down quite a bit, right? And as we get closer to the halving, it's potential that they continue to go down, but it's really hard to say, right? Mainly because it's just, we don't know what's gonna happen, right? We're in like uncharted territory right now with the freaking new all-time high prior to the halving, and everything is like pointing to it continuing, right? Like we keep bouncing, go down to 62, back up to 70, 62, 70. The market's kind of undecided. Things do look really good though. It's really hard to say what's gonna happen, right? So the prices are kind of iffy, and they may continue to go down prior to the halving, only because we all know that the profitability is gonna get hit pretty substantially if the price doesn't continue to increase pretty aggressively, right? So that's a big part of the reason, is that they kind of know that they're not gonna be the most appealing things in the world once that profitability does go down. If it continues though, right? There's so many variables though where it's really hard to say either way, right? What if Ordies and everything pops off again and those transaction fees go through the roof again? What if we continue at this rate? We're at 80, 90, 100K like a month after the halving. Who freaking knows, right? There's a ton of variables. You just have to decide like risk to reward, right? Does it make sense at this moment? How much lower can it go versus how much higher it can go? Right, and just depending on the model, for example, these guys could potentially go down a bit more, right? Just because there is more room, and we've seen it already, right? A lot of the stores had these just recently at like 5K. So anywhere to 5K, 5,500 for anything in stock. Future batches, right? The May, June batches, they had them lower. But now currently, right now in stock, you're able to get them in the low fours, okay? So something to consider. So certain models have more leeway. Like for me, the S19K Pros, best bang for the buck, but do they have a whole lot more room to go down even if things do get a little bit bearish? Probably not. I don't see them necessarily going down a ton more from here. Potentially, maybe they do. It's hard to say. If any of them go down, it would be those more expensive models, right? Specifically the S21. The M60 seems to be getting harder and harder to get, so that guy may not drop at all. That guy may see an increase, and even this guy may start going up, right? It's just gonna depend on demand, right? But if the halving comes and freaking all that stuff pops off, then expect the prices to go up, right? But it's up to you to determine what's a good price, what's not, and it just depends on your situation also, right? Like in reality, I was mentioning the S19K Pros are the better bang for the buck. But again, if you're an at-home miner, sometimes density is a factor. Like for me, if I were to convert to all BTC miners, that would be a factor, right? It would make more logical sense to get like six or eight of these things in comparison to two to three of the S21s. I don't necessarily have the room for that. Even though I have the electrical capacity, it's just the way my setup is. It's set up ideally for a max of like 4 to 5 ASICs, the way I have my like exhaust set up in the garage. So for me, if I were to consider it, it would definitely be more along the lines of something more dense, something like the S21, where I would be able to get it in one unit, right? Realistically, I would never convert all BTC, but I would definitely consider getting a BTC miner, and it would definitely be a more denser unit versus being one of these guys, right? Just because, again, space, like even just physical space for me, for the ASICs and my configuration is somewhat limited, right? So that is a factor to consider. But again, if that's not a factor for you, then definitely bang for the buck wise has been and it's probably going to continue to be these S19K Pros, right? But with this T21 now, it is kind of a game changer. We'll see how the price reflects, though. We'll see if they increase the price a little bit, because now this guy is suddenly more appealing because of this, because now we know we are able to do it, right? We kind of speculated and kind of made sense that they would be able to, but we didn't know if they were going to have some kind of limitation or something preventing you from doing that, which is probably why you have to use like LuxOS, for example. But it is doable. It has been done. And as a matter of fact, they said they did it in about 5 minutes. So one thing I do want to mention also, any of you guys who order T21s, let me know what ended up happening. I know a lot of the vendors, not just one or two, a lot of the vendors were still telling people that they were going to run on single phase also. Even though the Bitmain site and everything said that, nope, three phase only. Let me know what ended up happening. Did they end up refunding you? Did they end up doing something like this where they shipped it with an extra PSU or something? Let me know what the outcome was. I'm kind of curious. Or did they just concede and refund you guys, right? Because I know, find it really weird. Even he like messages a lot of them too. They're like, oh yeah, it's going to run on single phase. Even showing them the Bitmain site and showing that it's three phase. And they're like, oh no, yeah. Let me know how that went. If you guys got any resolution to that, let me know. But this does kind of open the window, especially if prices continue down, right? Because AlterTech has it at 35, but I know some of the other stores have it slightly lower. We'll see where the prices end up at, but it is just another interesting option, right? We'll see how things go, where they end up at. It is something I am looking at. I did mention one of the earlier videos that I did want to, the eventual long-term plan was to go out pretty much no ASIC, all GPU, just because it would be potentially a safer bet. Kind of want to have an ASIC or two also, right? And to be the safer bet ASIC, which one is it? It would be a BTC miner, right? So depending on how low they go, like I'm not super sold on the fact of getting one. So I'm okay with waiting till after the halving to see if there are any price drops. But if you are like dead set on getting one, the worth may not be the wait, right? Especially like when we weigh that risk versus reward, you have to really see if it's worth potentially saving a couple $100 versus the opposite happening. Prices increase, everything goes up through the roof, and now you kind of get left out, right? So that's kind of, I know some people have been on the fence, but realistically, if you were kind of really considering one, you should have gotten one quite a ways back. But if you're kind of on the fence like me, where I would get one if the price goes down low enough, I'm definitely open to it. We'll see what happens. I'm going to see after the halving. Maybe we get a nice little perfect storm of the halving comes, we go down to like 50K or something. Who knows? Maybe we get some deals. But again, realistically, the only deals would most likely happen on the more expensive units. I don't necessarily see like the S19K Pros going much lower only because they're so cheap already, right? Realistically, it would most likely not even necessarily be these guys. It would probably be like the S21s, which we've already seen. They were like 5K to 5,500. Now they're in the low fours already, right? So I would expect more from there. Potentially the What's Miners, the M60s, but it's already pretty limited, right? Those have actually been selling at least on the retail front. Some of them are starting to put MOQs and such already on them, so who knows there. But definitely very curious to see what happens, because it's something we've been thinking about for quite a while. The halving is less than a month away. It's crazy, right? So it's pretty cool to actually see everything kind of begin to play out, because again, it doesn't just affect, it affects the entire market, right? Everybody's very curious to see how the miners react, how the market reacts, and how what just happens in total, right? Like how many people end up unplugging, where does the hash rate go, where do the prices go? Who knows, right? So at least we're starting to get into those phases where we're gonna find out, right? So it's pretty exciting stuff. Again, even if you're not into BTC mining, it's gonna affect you, right? Again, BTC affects the entire crypto market. So realistically, if you're any kind of a miner, GPU miner, altcoin, whatever it is, what happens with Bitcoin will affect you, right? So something to think about. Again, I find it fascinating. And we'll see where the prices go. Maybe I end up getting one. Who knows? We'll see. We'll find out. But I just wanted to give you guys that update, as this is another pretty good option for next-gen BTC hardware. Let me know what you guys think. Are you guys considering getting one now? Does this kind of change your mind? Did you get one in the past? Did you just get S21? Or you're like, I don't want to deal with that. I'd rather just pay a couple $100 more and get S21. Let me know in the comments, guys. But again, huge shout out to AlterTech. I do have links in the description for any of this stuff if you guys are interested. Let me know in the comments, guys. Please comment, like, and subscribe. Thank you for watching, guys. And I am out.